Regardless of what organism you study in a molecular biology lab, chances are you'll also work with bacteria because they're little DNA factories that are essential for creating the genetic material we need for lots of different experiments. In order to keep our bacteria happy, we need to feed them. So today we'll learn how to make their food. Bacteria food is called LB, which is short for life broth. Yum. Here's what we'll need. A whey boat. LB powder, which contains yeast and salts that are delicious for the bacteria. It conveniently comes pre-mixed by many lab supply companies, or you can make your own, but today we'll be using the pre-mixed variety. A glass Erlenmeyer flask. This is the container we'll be making our LB in, and is also where we'll eventually grow our bacteria. Yeah, they like to swim in their food. A stir bar. Aluminum foil. Reverse osmosis, or RO water. A graduated cylinder. And autoclave tape. Okay, let's make our LB. You'll want to check the label of your LB powder, but very often it's formulated so that we should use 20 grams of powder per 1 liter of solution. We want to make 500 milliliters of LB today, so first let's use a scale to measure out 10 grams of LB powder onto our whey boat. Next, pour the powder into the Erlenmeyer flask. Rinse the whey boat with RO water so that any residual powder winds up in the flask. Then measure out around 450 milliliters of RO water using a graduated cylinder and pour it into the Erlenmeyer, making sure to wash any powder residue down the sides of the flask. Add a magnetic stir bar and stir until the LB powder is dissolved. To make sure there are no LB powder clumps remaining, hold the flask up to the light. The Erlenmeyer does not have accurate volume markings on it, so we need to pour the solution back into the graduated cylinder. You can use another magnet to make sure your stir bar doesn't fall out while you do this. Bring the volume up to 500 milliliters with more RO water, and then transfer it back into the flask. Cap it with tin foil and add a piece of autoclave tape. The tape is white now, but will reveal black stripes if it's been successfully sterilized. Now it's ready to take to the autoclave. The autoclave will sterilize the LB, eliminating any random bacteria that might be hanging out in the flask, and will leave behind a clean home for the bacteria that we actually want to grow in the lab. First, we place the flask in a tray inside the autoclave, in case something goes wrong and the liquid boils over or the flask breaks. Then it'll spill in the tray and not all over the bottom of the autoclave. You can add a half inch of tap water to the bottom of the tray, which will help to heat the LB more evenly. In some autoclaves, you can also put a beaker of water in the tray and place a temperature sensor in the water. This will tell the autoclave what the liquid's temperature is, which can help it run a more accurate cycle than if it were just reading the temperature of the air inside the chamber. Autoclaves have different settings depending on how long you want to sterilize something and whether that something contains a liquid. In this case, we'll set it for a 20-minute liquid cycle and then press start. You can see the actual time is well over 20 minutes because it takes a while to gradually pressurize and depressurize the chamber. And after 100 or so minutes, our LB is ready to come out of the autoclave. Our indicator tape is showing its stripes, so we know the LB was successfully sterilized. Woohoo! But wait until it cools before feeding it to your bacteria.
LB is not delicious if it boils you alive.